Welcome viewers. Today we are going to discuss an important course of your discipline, that is BTech Mechanical in Computer Integrated Manufacturing. We are going to discuss industrial engineering and operation research, which is a part of your course curriculum. The course code for this course is BME035. That is industrial engineering and operation research. This is a very important topic, or you can say a part of your course curriculum that has been kept in your course with certain aspects keeping in mind, because whenever you are going, whether you are working in company or you are working in a service sector, you always need to optimize the situation. Now, the industrial engineering and operational research always provide you an aid, so that you are in a better position. You are in a better position to advise. You are in better position to suggest a modified form of functioning of the system, whether it is in manufacturing, whether it is in service. So today we are going, first we will see this slide, that as an industrial engineering, suppose you got an idea for a new product. Even better, suppose many people wants to buy it. First, it's a really good thing that you got an idea. You have a, at least you can think, you can innovate, and you are coming with a good idea of a new product. But what you will do? How are you going to make it? This is a million-dollar question, because only having an idea is not sufficient. You must have also resources to make it. Then how many workers will you need? Because suppose you are making a furniture or you are making a simple cube, even for that you need workers, so that they can work and they can produce the item desired by you. Similarly, how many items can they produce? Suppose you are keeping one worker, he must have some certain productivity. He can produce 8 items in a day or 1 item in a day. So you have to keep in mind how many workers you have to put, so that a desired number of outputs you can always get after the end of each day. Similarly, what kind of system will help them to make more? If suppose they are working in a simplest system. Now you must think that how you can improve the system so that their productivity and their production can improve further. What kind of parts will they need to make it? Now, it may be a simple product, it may be a complex product. Simple product means composed of only one item. A complex product may be composed of many items. So when we talk about the complex product, it is always advisable to see that what are the different items which can be manufactured and different production line, and then can be assembled at one place. Now, how much you can keep on hand? Now, this is another important part of your thinking, that doing all the activities from starting this to this, you need some finance. So how much you have to need the capital for making the product, for running a factory? Now, such questions can be answered by industrial engineer. Now, if these questions are challenging and you are thinking to do, then this means you are going to adopt a challenging career of an industrial engineer. Now, do you know that an industrial engineer always work for the system? That means he will make the system. Even suppose we talk about the hospital or for the operation theater, industrial engineer will make the system so that a doctor can get the instrument at right time from the nurse, and even the nurse can locate an instrument at right time, so that doctor can operate the patient at right time. So that is the work or the function of an industrial engineer. So if you read this slide, that industrial engineers made the surgery easier for the doctors. Now, what are the different problems faced by an industrial engineer? Just like if we have recently have the this book on Harry Potter. Now, suppose there is a corner bookstore shop. Now, he always liked to know that how many copies he should keep so that he should not face a situation of unsold book or a stock out position. Unsold book means the customers are not coming to him, or a stock out position that customers are coming but he does not have books to provide them. So these two, in order to come out of these two situations, an industrial engineer always help a bookkeeper so that he may have the optimum number of copies of any famous book, so that the customer may not go without that book. Then how many people will need to work for a factory so that a sufficient number of items can be made for fulfilling the customer demand. Similarly, now stock items can rise or fall. So industrial engineer can always predict what should be the, or what would be the situation in coming days. Suppose, so these are the three important problems always faced by an industrial engineer, and industrial engineer is always ready to solve this problem. For example, I told regarding the number of books, it may be number of books, it may be number of items. Similarly, it may be number of workers, or he can also optimize or simulate the total functioning of a stock exchange, and he can predict that what will be the output or what will be the consequences of certain constant on stock market in coming future. Now, if you see this next slide, that industrial engineer always takes the help of math, science, business and psychology to answer all these questions. As an industrial engineer, you always learn how to create a factory, how to make the schedule, how to determine the delivery routes and set the customer service system, and much more. Industrial engineer also tries to learn that how to improve the ways in which the factory, hospital or other organizations run. They always take many factors into account, from equipment to the material. Now, in this industrial engineering and operation research topic, the course, we have six blocks, starting with the introduction to industrial engineering, work system design, product design and development, ergonomics, operation research and application, and decision making tool. If you see the first block, in which we are going to elaborate you or explain you about the industrial engineering, that what are the different component of industrial engineering, just like introduction to industrial engineering, system approach to industrial engineering, then changing phase of industrial engineering, because industrial engineering is has been changed from, if you see the right from 1700 to 2000, there is a lot many changes occurred in the industrial engineering. So we have to know that what are the different phases of the industrial engineering which has occurred in the industrial engineering. Then productivity is an important topic, because an industrial engineer always talks about the productivity improvement. Whenever he applies any mechanism or tools, he always try that a system must be improved. So system must be improved, that means the productivity should enhance. So in this unit 4 on productivity, we have tried that all the different types of productivity have been explained. Then we have also tried to solve many numericals, so that you may get an idea that what is the productivity. Similarly, in the last unit, we are talking about the innovation and technology management. Now, innovation and technology management is directly related with the industrial engineer, because industrial engineer always look what should be the new way of doing a job, or what would be the efficient way of doing the job. So he must always see the new job or new way of doing job. So that is the innovation. So in this, all the five units will drive you that what is the industrial engineering, how the innovation and the technology is related with the industrial engineering, and what are the different types of productivity, why the productivity is important for an industrial engineering, and what is the history of industrial engineering, how the industrial engineering has been changed from 1700 to in the today's, in the modern form of computer age. Now if we see the second block, in this block we are covering the work system design. This covers the four units and we normally talks about the work study, method study, time study, and the standard data and the PMT. Now in this block we are discussing an important tool applied or used by an industrial engineer. Now when you see the this content of this block, we are going to discuss about the work study. Now what is work study? Work study is a simple, or in a simple definition if we give, it's a, it tries to improve the working of a method. Similarly, in a method study and time study, we provide you a proper time for doing a job. What is the standard time of doing job? Similarly, in method study, we will always identify that what is the suitable method so that we can reduce the wastage of time. Similarly, standard data and the PMT system, we try to record the activities of a operation so that we can identify that what are the different activities which are not useful for an operation. So we can minimize, and we can also reduce the time for a completion of an operation. Now the third block is devoted to the product design and the development. This block contains four units, and basically this block is about the product design, how you will do the product design as an industrial engineer, because every product has a four stages of its life. First your growth period, then maturity, then saturation, and then decline. If you see that as an industrial engineer, you always see that a product design plays an important role. So we have also discussed the tools and techniques of product design, then the factors affecting the product design, and the fourth unit is very, very important because it takes the environmental consideration. Suppose you are a part of a firm who is making computer or making the printer. So you must aware that what are the different constraints by the environmentalist for making these product, because these aspects must be considered from the beginning at the design stage. Now we come to the block fourth, which is on ergonomics. Now ergonomics block contains the three unit. First is your man-machine system, ergonomics and product design, environment and human productivity. In all these three unit, we have tried to emphasize that if as an industrial engineer, you must see that how the man is interacting with the machine. Similarly, what should be the ergonomically design of a product so that a man or the worker should not feel stressed. Similarly, what is the effect of environment on the human productivity. Now operation research is an important tool used by an industrial engineer, and in this block we are covering a linear programming, transportation models, assignment, and stochastic model. These all three units covers are tools. These are not the sufficient, but we always try so to give you the maximum input in this three unit. Sixth block is on decision making tool, because an industrial engineer always utilizes decision making tools, just like simulation in industrial engineering, game theory, and multi objective and the priority making decision tool. In the priority making decision tool, we are discussing two important tools, just like analytical hierarchy process, that is AHP, and analytical network process, that is ANP, in which we are going to have the multi criteria and multi different types of methods, out of which you have to select one. So by using AHP and ANP, we can come to a better solution by choosing the better solution. Now we will come to the history of the industrial engineering. Because when we see the progress in the industrial engineering, we always remember one name, that is Frederick W. Taylor, who has done a pioneer work in the field of industrial engineering, starting from the doing the scientific management of laying the bricks. He always tried to focus on the human aspect of production and the productivity. If you see the time period between 1882 to 1912, the important work in the industrial engineering is factory system, then incentive system, scheduling, and the Gantt chart. These are the important work which has been carried out during this period. After that, the main work focuses on the predetermined time standard, value analysis, system analysis. On the other hand, we have an operation research technique, just like which has brought the revolution and changed the scope of the industrial engineering. Now in the present, what is the present state? Now in the present state, the industrial engineering constitute of value engineering, operation research, CPM, that is critical path method, and PERT, program evaluation and review technique, then ergonomics or human engineering, then the aspects of system analysis, advances in the information technology and computer package, and different types of mathematical and the statistical tools which helps an industrial engineer to solve the problems of complex world of today. Now if we see the core definition of industrial engineering, that industrial engineering is a field which concerns the design, improvement, and installation of an integrated system of people, material, equipment, energy, and technology. And if we see the definition provided by American Institute of Industrial Engineer, that is bringing together and effective utilization of various resources to facilitate the efficient production operation. Now we will focus on the what is the effective utilization of resources. Effective utilization means people, material, information, and equipment. These are the input resources. They are used in a right way so that they form an integrated combination to meet the production and operation objectives. Now, if we see the scope of the industrial engineering, first scope is the design and the improvement of the condition. Condition may be internal, condition may be external. Then second scope is the design and improvement of the organization. Third, design and improvement of the workplace, method, and the procedure. And the fourth scope is the design and improvement of the product and the services. We will take one by one. First, we are taking the design and improvement of the condition. In this, as I have already told you, that it may be external or it may be internal. when we talk about the external, in the external comes the vendor development and the customer research analysis, need analysis. What is meant by the vendor development? That means the person who is supplying the items to you or equipment to you. So as an industrial engineer, you always try so that your vendor may be reliable. Your vendor must be reliable up to the extent that he should provide you the material at right time, so that you can produce the material also at right time, so to the customer. And if you talk about the internal, then ergonomics is the most important industrial engineering tool. And in this you see just it is lighting, noise, vibration and fatigue and ventilation. Now as an industrial engineer, when we talk about the internal aspects, then these just like ergonomics, lighting, noise, vibration, fatigue and ventilation plays an important role, because as per the Hawthorne study, these issues play an important role in improving or decreasing the productivity of a worker. Now if you see that operation research, organizational issues and the decision theory, they constitute the part of design and improvement of organization. Similarly, if you see that how you will go for the design and improvement of workplace method and procedure, then first item which comes as a work study. Second is your system analysis, means an industrial engineer always look at the problem from the systemic point of view. He does not see in isolation. The third is the layout planning. Where is your factory or whatever product you are making, layout planning is very, very important. And this role is played by industry engineering, so that the number of material handling or the material handling can be minimized. The total transportation distance between one resource to another resource can be minimized by a proper layout planning. Then overall planning consisting of your worker planning, your factory planning, your resource planning. Then directing, how you will direct your resources so that you may get the right quantity at right time. Then control, you always need the overall control on the workers. Then the last is the scheduling, how you will schedule so that a one worker cannot be overstressed. Similarly, one machine cannot remain idle for a longer time. Now we will come to the design and improvement of products and the services. First is the total quality management. It always takes the help of total quality management, so he gets the improvement in the product. Similarly, value engineering also provide an aid to industry engineer for improving the product and services. Then business process re-engineering, he will redefine the process. He will redefine the process that what is the next best process for making this product or facilitating the service. Then benchmarking. Benchmarking is also an important. He always see that what is the best available in the market or in the world, so that he will benchmark it and then accordingly he will try to improve its own process. Now we will see that how the industrial engineering has been developed from 1800 in the today's scenario. First phase we called is as a phase one. Now this phase is known as pre-industrial revolution era, where there is no machine, the people were working by their hand, and normally this period is up to 1800. Now we will come to the phase two. Phase two is named as industrial revolution, when the steam engine was invented by James Watt, and there was a concept of factory, and there was an owner for a factory, there were different workers working for the factory and making a desired product. This period is from early 1800 to late 1800. Third phase is called the scientific management phase, and this period is from 1819 to 1940. In this period, basically the Taylor, Adam Smith, Gilbert, they all contributed for the scientific management. There were lot of theories, just like first the scientific management theory provided by Taylor, then the Wealth of Nation provided by Adam Smith, and then the Gilbert, they provide along with his wife, he provided a number of theories, so which are very, very important in even today's scenario. The fourth scenario or the fourth phase is the operation research and the quantitative phase, and this started from 1940 to 1980. In this period, a number of different operation research techniques have been, or quantitative techniques have been evolved or developed, and they were so fruitful that even in the computer age, we are taking the help of those techniques. And if we see the new era, that is the phase fifth, where we see always automation, computer integrated manufacturing, and it has started from 1980, and still we are in this age. Now we see that the role of an industrial engineer. Industrial engineer always work as an expert. He is advisor and consultant. Then he works as an analyst of the system. Then he is a trainer and he is a decision maker. Now as an expert, what he does? He helps in designing the system. He expert in the new technology. So he provides his expertise to the system. Now as an advisor and consultant, he interprets the data, he reviews the data, he advises for improvement and suggests the productivity tools. Similarly, as an analyst of system, he always identifies the system faults and analyzes the job and coordinate between or among different departments, because industrial engineer is the soul who can interact with many departments, so he works as a coordinator. Now as a trainer, he always tries to motivate the worker, he trains the worker, he applies new technology and helps in making the work study. Now as a trainer, he always identify the area in which he can provide the training to the worker so that the productivity of the system can be improved. Now as a decision maker, he always use the operation research and the quantitative techniques so that he can reach to a optimal decision. Similarly, he tries to develop operation research techniques and quantitative techniques. He used the management information system, computers and IT tools. He uses all these for making the effective decision. That is the main idea of an industrial engineer, because the whole factory or whole the service industry company always see at his or its industrial engineer. So industrial engineer plays a very, very important role, as an expert, as an advisor or consultant, as an analyst, as a trainer, and as a decision maker. Now if we see the application of an industrial engineering, it can be in manufacturing or it can be in service sector. If we see in the manufacturing, just like first is the formulation of production plan, control of process and product, then inventory control, design of plant layout, scheduling of machines and the process. Now if you see all these five applications in the manufacturing, you will always see that the first one is starting in the manufacturing, because he has to see how to make the production plan so that they can be effectively formulated. Similarly, what are the different ways to control the processes and the product manufacturing? What are the different components in the inventory control, and how he can design the plant layout? Similarly, how the machine and the processes can be scheduled. Similarly, if we see the service sector, then he is involved in the construction or the project planning. He is also associated, or he or she is also associated with the airlines operation, hospital management, transportation problems, and the optimal use of resources, which is very, very important for the service sector. Now, these are the some of the major activities which comes under an industrial engineering, just like decision making, designing the production system, dealing with the new technology. Similarly, more important is the interpretation of data and the review of previous data. Similarly, advising for improvement, dealing with the productivity improvement, and the most important, identifying the system faults. Because as an industrial engineer, he must have the ability to identify the fault in the system, exact fault of the system. Similarly, he should be able to analyze the jobs at the micro level and different aspects, just like applying new technology, using management and information system or IT. All these are the activities carried out by an industrial engineer. Now, if we see that industrial engineering and the production management, these two courses are always create some confusion for the student as well as for the expert, because the course curriculum of industrial engineering and the production management overlaps with each other. So when we are talking about the industrial engineering, we must be able to differentiate between industrial engineering and production management. And industrial engineering and the production management are correlated, or you can say related. Many areas of industrial engineering are also the areas of a production management. And if you see this slide, this will help you in differentiating between the two. The focus of industrial engineering is on design, analysis, planning, and the control, while the production management focuses on the management of the production system. Similarly, industrial engineers do not operate the system, they design. What does it mean? That an industrial engineer always try to build the system. He always formulate the system, while the production management always work for the system, or he always become a part of the production system. If you see this difference, industrial engineer, the role of industrial engineer is a role of staff function. They always advise the line manager. Now, who are the line manager? Now, these production manager are the line manager. They are directly responsible on the shop floor, while the industrial engineer are not directly responsible for the shop floor activities. Now, these are the some of the tools which are normally used by an industrial engineer. Just like first is your method study. Now, what is a method study? If you see that it is a simple way to identify a better method for doing a job. Better method or an effective method of doing job. Similarly, a time study. Under the time study, we always try to compute the time for carrying out an activity, and we see that what is the ideal or effective time for completing an activity. Then motion economy. In this tool or technique, we analyzes the motion and we see that what are the different motions which are not necessary or which can be avoided. Similarly, the value analysis always see that there should not be any unnecessary cost or there should not be any activity which is not value addition, not value added. Then next is your production planning and control. This area or this tool is always utilized by or applied by an industrial engineer because this helps in proper scheduling, controlling the production, because because as an industry engineer, the main emphasis is to produce the right quantity and the right quality of the product at predetermined time and pre-established cost. So production planning and control plays an important role. Similarly, if you come to the inventory control always seeks the economic lot size. Similarly, the reorder level. Now, with the help of inventory control, an industrial engineer can always estimate that what is the economic lot size of the product which we are going to produce or the raw material from which we are going to produce that particular product. So this economical lot size will always help to optimize the total inventory holding cost as well as inventory carrying cost. Next is your job evaluation. Now job evaluation means industry engineer always see that a particular operator must get a job according to his skill, his or her skill. That means if a worker is specialized in a particular field, he always should be assigned the work of the similar type. So this is the work of an industrial engineer, to evaluate the job performed by the different worker and to see that what type of change he can make. From the job evaluation, he can also estimate whether this job is of simple type or complex type, or in other words, it is a general type of a work job or it is type a special purpose job. If it needs the special skill, then we can provide a higher incentive or higher pay to the worker. So in this way, the job evaluation always try to help in categorizing the different types of jobs, as well as accordingly industry engineer can formulate or can build the different incentive or different salary structure as per the jobs of the worker. Now the next is the material handling analysis. Now in this, the most objective criteria is to eliminate the unnecessary movement. That means he has to select the material handling equipment so that there should not be any unnecessary movement of the job from one source to another source. Next is your ergonomics, which is also known as human factor engineering. In this we study the relationship between man and his working condition. That means the effort of an industrial engineer is to make the environment so that the worker should not feel stress. Now the next is operation research technique. In this we always take the help of linear programming, simulation model, queuing model, network analysis, assignment, dynamic and integer programming and games. And the ultimate objective is to arrive at optimal solution. That means we have certain constraint or certain limitations, and by using these tools we can arrive at the optimal solution. Now we will see that what is the significance of an industrial engineer, why an industrial engineer is important for an organization. If you see the first point, it says that only industrial engineering is the department which can examine the method and its certification. That means as an industrial engineer you can interact with the different departments. You can see, you are authorized to see that what are their methods, and you can certify whether this method is suitable for that job or for that department or not. So these are the work carried out by the industrial engineer. Similarly, IE is the department that decides the time required for an activity to accomplish. Because it is not the simple. Suppose there is some drilling machine and the worker has to drill and then take out that particular product. Then as an industrial engineer, you have to define the time with the stopwatch. You have to see that what is the time for completing that product. So it is not up to the worker that how much time is required or how much time he is taking by using all his facility and basic needs. So as an industrial engineer, what is the job of an industrial engineer? He will take the stopwatch, he will take a standard worker, and under the effective working environment he will start the stopwatch and he will say to start the worker drilling, and he will record the time. And not only the one worker, he will take the at least 5 to 6 to 10 to 50 workers, and he will take the mean of that, and then he will define that for drilling only 3 minutes or 5 minutes are required. So in today's lecture we have introduced this topic and we have taken only first block of the course, that is Introduction to Industrial Engineering. In this block we have covered the history of the industrial engineering and how the industrial engineering has been developed or progressed right from 1800 to 2007. The different tools used by an industrial engineer, just like linear programming, simulation, operation research, these are the several tools. So in the coming series of the lecture we are going to cover the second block, and you will find it very interesting and useful for the study of your course. Thank you.